Going on, everybody. We are here to do yet another replay video. Surprise, surprise. I know, you're blown away by the unpredictable nature of the channel. So, what we have here is Jackbrody from POW, one of the very few OW clans out there worth talking about, because the rest of them are horrible. Or at least they seem to be in the pub matches I play. Jackbrody is just kind of getting going in the Tank Destroyers, something that I know a considerable amount about, because that's pretty much what I played exclusively for a while. And he's out here with his SU-100. He does not have the big gun on it. I can tell this because it doesn't have a giant muzzle brake on the end. Or maybe he does. I haven't played mine in a while, so I could be wrong about that. We'll be able to tell with his first shot. If he does around 300 to 400 damage, then yeah, I'm gonna go out and guess that it's probably the big gun. Now, on his team, he has the hilarious and much sought after TOG 2, here and after known as the HMS Hilarious. And the other team seems to be made up of a lot of Russian tanks. That's kind of cool. Deadheadser. Go get me a Hitzer. Now, the good thing about the SU-100 is that it is quick. For a tank destroyer, it is quite fast. We'll do 40 or 50 kilometers per hour. Hey, look, there's a Hellcat. Oh, look, we've been shot. Not by 70 points of damage. That's not really a whole lot of damage. I wonder what that was. Oh, yep, that's the big gun. That's the big gun right there. For some reason or other, I thought the muzzle brake was a lot bigger than that, but not so much. Now, he's actually, you'd think he's in kind of an exposed position here, but he's actually pretty well hidden because of the contours of the cliff to his right. The artillery piece, if it's camping the base at, like, K1 there, there's nothing that he can do to hit him, at least not that I'm aware of. That ridge line really serves as a pretty good barrier. And behold the vanishing KV-1. Now you see him, now he's dead. Cromwell's gonna go out there, probably get killed by the Hellcat. Because he went by himself into a highly exposed position. Hey, you got him. That's kind of interesting. And being the precision marksman that Jackbrody is, completely meant to do that and not do damage. That's called surgical precision. That's what that is. This one, however, that one was meant to kill. He was just playing with it before. Now it's all serious time. Now, if we can get a shot into that Su-100Y over there, the premium equivalent, it will probably just end up being dead, because, quite frankly, the problem is that at that distance with that gun, it's a dicey proposition, even if you have, like, a full-on target. Just having a corner to shoot at is not a likely, gonna be a likely proposition. Luckily enough, we have medium tanks that are perfectly willing to make us look awesome by driving straight at our gun. Thanks, medium tank! Zoinks! Oh, there we go. And at this point, I just noticed, actually, that Jackbrody's been firing gold the whole time. It's not really a thing you need to do in this tank. You generally see only 7s, and even 7s, tier 7s can, I mean, you can penetrate those pretty readily. It's the tier 8s frontally that are a problem, and, well, some of them anyway. Again, at that distance, kind of a dicey proposition. It may work and it may do that. Russian guns are not extremely accurate at distance, at least not at this tier. Once you start climbing tiers, they seem to be, it's not so much the accuracy that goes up, but the muzzle velocity, and therefore the round is kind of easier to track and predict. That was, I don't know what that was. That was just foolish. Jackbrody, I demand better of you. You cannot snapshot. If you're fully aimed in, you cannot snapshot with that thing. I'm going to eat you, little fishy. Come out, wherever you are. Except that I know exactly where you are. And I know that you're not smart enough not to get shot. Just like that. Got really lucky on that snapshot, I'm going to tell you that right now. Well played, sir. Now, they seem to be trying to get in our base. That might be a problem. Dun, 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 dun. Nope, can't get him. And why a Hellcat is still in the base, I don't know. I would have to assume that he doesn't know what the hell he's driving. Because that is one fast tank destroyer. If you thought the Su-100 was fast, the Hellcat is crazy fast. Now, if he drives out there, he's going to get shot in the ass. So what we're going to do is wait for him to come to us. And then we're going to do that. No, no! They got Pedro. I mean, Pablo. I mean, Pavel? Could be. Shoot him! Shoot him! Shoot him with a gun! There you go. Now we healed the loader. We are capturing the base. However, there's one medium back there versus at least one, yeah, just one heavy. So that's not going to work. That's going to end up being a very dead situation here pretty quick. Which means that we have to break up the cap on our base. If we do not, we will lose. Hey, look, the idiot drove off the cap. There is, well, he either drove off the cap or got shot. Either way, it doesn't really matter. We must break up the cap. Now, I believe the KV-1 was there first, but I'm proven wrong. The Mighty Beaver occupado very much longer. Now, we can either kill the Mighty Beaver, or we can shoot the other guy and break up the cap further. Gotcha. Probably wise to take the gun out of the fight. And, for Top Gun, do I hear... Top Gun, I do. So that is Top Gun for the Jackbrody. He is now heads up against the KV-1S. Problem is that he's only got 27% health. That's 155 health points. And the KV-1S can one-shot him. Now, if the KV-1S is in a similar situation, that is also true in both... That's actually a good move. Knock down that tree. That's even more cover. So... Depending on his health, we may be able to one-shot him. And from the T-34, we get a message saying that the KV-1S is at 15% health, which means that's well within the realm of just slaughtering him. And now we wait. And I could probably speed this up and make it less painful to watch, but that's not really my style. So we are going to wait, and I'm going to make you imagine the Jaws theme song in your head, because I'm too lazy to even say that. The binoculars have kicked on, camo net's kicked on. I think he's missing some gear if he's using camo net and binoculars. I run mine with Vince Rammer and binoculars, and he's obviously, I think he's only using the Rammer. If you put Vince on there, everything gets better. So I would recommend it. I use Vince Rammer and binoculars on all my tank destroyers. Unless, of course, they're open top, in which case you get Vince for free. In which case, you go with probably gun laying drive for aiming speed. Sorry, I'll stop that. What do we have to comment? Hey, we had a Steps 2 on the team. That's... kind of weird. See, I'm not that lazy. Well, maybe I'm just weak-willed. All right, fine, we'll speed it up a little bit. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Nope, still nothing going on. And it's going to take the KV-1S forever to try and come get us. Apparently. 4x speed. Back down to 2x speed. Ridiculous speed! We went into plaid for a second. So at this point, I would like to reiterate that we indeed have secured Top Gun. However, the enemy tank has 5 kills, so should he have killed us and done more damage, he would get Top Gun. That is the way of the tanks. The tanks giveth, and the tanks taketh away. And my chair squeaks. Hey, there he is! Oh god, he's gonna kill us, oh god. Probably not, though. So we spotted him coming around the hill, which gives us plenty of time to do this. Well, or something. I don't know, man. That's the kind of the cardinal sin of using Russian anything, is you cannot rush that shot. You have to aim, you have to have a tight reticle if you're taking any kind of distance shot whatsoever. And if you're in an IS tank and trying to snipe, you're doing it wrong. You are actually hurting your team by trying to snipe in an IS-based tank. Unless, of course, you are in the Object 268. Looky, looky. Ha! Catch. I love playing catch. So, there's 7 kills in the SU-100. I have done that myself, and it is a glorious feeling. The SU-100 is actually my most played tank, and I still haven't got a Radley Walters in it. I don't know what the deal is with that. Just bad luck on my part, I guess. So that's been Jackbrody in his SU-100, and that's been me. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up or down, and or tell your friends about it. Peace out.